मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज प्रीति मोरे एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टूडेज यूट्यूब वीडियो. टूडे वी आर गोइंग इन आर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड यूनिट 6 मेन ऑक्सिलरी एंड मॉडल वर्ब. नाउ ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स वी हैव कंप्लीटेड. दिस ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स आर विच कम्स बिफोर द मेन वर्ब. ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब मीन्स द वर्ब विच कम्स बिफोर द मेन वर्ब, द वर्ब विच हेल्प्स द मेन वर्ब. सो which are the auxiliary verbs we have seen? Am, is, are, was, were, have, has, had, do, does, did. These are the auxiliary verb we have seen. Now today we are going to see the modal auxiliaries. What modal auxiliary do? Modal auxiliary can't be used as main verb. Modal auxiliary is also not a main verb, and we can't use the modal auxiliary verb as main verb. Modal auxiliary comes before the main verb. As like the auxiliary verb, this auxiliary verbs also comes before the main verb. Like that only, modal auxiliaries also comes before the main verb. It also comes before the main verb. Now, what modal auxiliary tell us? Modal auxiliary tell us about the ability, possibility, and so on. If we want to take a permission or to give permission, so some words are there, some modal auxiliaries are there, which is very useful, and we use that all the modal auxiliaries in our daily routine sentences also. So it tell us about the ability and possibility. So which are the modal auxiliaries? Let's write on the board. So I write here the modal auxiliaries: can, could, may, might, shall, will, must, should. Only this much, there are so many modal auxiliaries, but in the 6th standard you just have to learn about these modal auxiliaries: can, could. This is the present and its past tense is could. May is the present form and its past form is might. Shall, will we use in the future tense to show the future action. Now must and should, these are the modal auxiliaries. Can, could, may, might, shall, will, must, should. These modal auxiliaries you have to learn, you have to study in standard 6. But how to use, when to use can, could, may, might, shall, will, must, should, when to use that all the modal auxiliaries, we'll see in the sentences. First, you write down this and this also in your notebook, so you can get which are the modal auxiliaries. If I ask in the questions, which, write down the modal auxiliaries. So you, these are the modal auxiliaries you have to write then: can, could, may, might, shall, will, must, and should. These are the modal auxiliaries you have to write in the answer. So you just note down this, then we'll see the examples of different modal auxiliaries. Now I hope student you have written this. So I just rub this. Now let's see the examples. Modal auxiliary comes before the main verb. It comes before the main verb and it tells us about the ability and the possibility. So first we'll see the example of can and could. Modal verb can and could. It shows the ability. It shows the ability. So I just write here ability. To show the ability we use can, and in the past we use could. So let's see some examples. First example I write here. I can speak in English. I can speak in English. That means the ability. That means I am able to speak in English. Or I can change the subject here also. You can speak in English. That means you have ability to speak in English. आप English में बोल सकते हो. That means can. आप ये कर सकते हो. आप swim कर सकते हो. आप पढ़ाई कर सकते हो. You can read. You can swim. You can run. So again I take the second sentence. You can swim. You can swim. आप swim कर सकते हो. That means कर सकते हो means this can, this ability. You have ability of swimming. So this can is here, this can is here to show the particular ability. Now again this the present form. Now the third I use you could. You could get good marks. Now you could get good marks. आपको अच्छे marks मिल सकते थे. That means in the past can become could if we say some sentence and if we have to show some ability in the past. That time we use could. आपको अच्छे marks मिल सकते थे. So this could is there. Now let's see some example whether is there in your textbook. My grandfather could skate. Could skate well when she was younger. When she was younger. Now my grandfather could skate well. My grandmother. My grandmother could skate well when she was younger. जब मेरी grandmother अच्छे से skating कर सकती थी. That means it was in the past. And if we say the same sentence in the present, मेरी grandmother अच्छे से skating कर सकती है. Hey means present. My grandmother can skate well. Done. If the same sentence we have to say in the past, that time we use could. So my grandmother could skate well when she was younger. If I say आपको अच्छे marks मिल सकते हैं, you have ability to get good marks, so you can get good marks. आपको अच्छे marks मिल सकते हैं, आपको अच्छे marks मिल सकते थे. So that time we use could in the past, and in the present we use can. So you just write down this all four examples in your notebook. Can, could to show the ability. We use can, could to show the ability. Now we'll see the use of can, could or may again. We can use can, could to show the ability also, and we use can, could to take a permission or for give a permission also. First you just do this, then we'll see the use of can, could and may. I hope students you have written these four sentences and you just underline this can and could here. Now the uses of can, could or may. Can, could or may. We use can, could or may for giving permission or taking permission. For giving permission, taking and asking permission. So when we use can, could, we use to show the ability also, and can, could, may we use for giving permission and taking permission. So let's see some examples. The first example, can I borrow this book? Can I borrow this book? क्या मैं ये book ले सकता हूँ? Can I borrow this book? That means here is the permission. So here while asking question and while asking the permission, that time we use can I borrow this book? So answer is yes, you can borrow. Now the second is, but when we ask this can for the permission, if we are just talking with our friend circle or with our family, for the informal form we use can. Here between friend, now the next sentence, may I come in? This may is also here for the permission. Here also may I come in, मतलब मैं अंदर आ सकता हूँ. This is also the permission. Here also the permission, but there is little difference between the can and may. May is the formal, when we ask to our teachers or for some professional work, that time we use may for a permission. And if we are just talking about or getting permission with our friend circle, with our family, that time we use can for the permission. So this is the formal use of may. Now could, if we have to, when we have to ask permission very politely, when we have to speak very politely, that time we use could. Could you switch on the fan? More polite than can. More polite, that means here with the use of could we can request also. Could you do this for me? आप मेरे लिए ये कर सकोगे? That means the could is very polite, बहुत अच्छे से पूछना. That means the could. Could you switch on the fan? Could you switch on fan? Sorry, the is also there, I forgot to write. And question mark. For asking the polite permission, we use could. For request also, we use could. Could you do this? Could you do my homework? Could you help me for doing my homework? So I just write here again the example of could. Could you help me for doing the homework? So here we are just requesting, could you do this for me? Could you do that for me? Could you switch on the fan? Could you help me? Could you buy the paint for me when you go to the market? Could you buy paint for me? That means many of the polite request we can do by using could. We can do the polite request by using this could. And when we have to be a formal, that time we use may. And while we have to take permission between our friend circle or among with our family members, that time we use can. And for formal we use may. And for more polite, for request, we use could. That means for giving permission and asking permission, we use can, could or may, these auxiliaries. So you just note down these examples also in your notebook. I hope student you got when use can could as a ability to show the ability and can could may for giving permission and asking permission. Now let's see shall and will to show the future action. To show the future action. Now I just rub this. I hope you written. Now use of shall, will. For future action. We use shall for I and we. When I and we will be there, that time we use shall, and the other subject is there, that time we use will. So let's see the example to show the future action. We use shall and will. So the first example I write. We shall arrive on time. We shall arrive on time. हम टाइम पे पहुंच जाएंगे. दैट मीन्स दिस एक्शन इज नॉट कंप्लीटेड येट एंड नॉट हैपनिंग येट बट इट विल हैपन इन द फ्यूचर. दैट मीन्स हम टाइम पे पहुंच जाएंगे. सो दिस इज द फ्यूचर. टू शो द फ्यूचर एक्शन वी यूज शाल एंड विल. दे विल बी लेट. They will be late. वो late हो सकते, वो late होंगे. They will be late. वो late होंगे. If some function is there but someone is coming late and they just inform us they will be late, so that time they will be late. वो late होंगे. That means in future. This is also the future action. I shall become a teacher. That means in future I shall become a teacher. मैं teacher बनूंगी in future. You will call me at नाइट. आप मुझे रात में कॉल करोगे. दैट मीन्स द फ्यूचर. ही विल वॉच मूवी टू नाइट. वो आज रात मूवी देखेगा. मीन्स दिस ऑल आर द फ्यूचर एक्शंस. आई जस्ट अंडरलाइन हियर एंड यू जस्ट नोट डाउन दिस एग्जाम्पल्स इन योर नोटबुक. वी यू शाल विल टू शो द फ्यूचर एक्शन. यू जस्ट नोट डाउन ऑल द एग्जाम्पल्स इन योर नोटबुक. Now I hope student you have written this all the sentences. Now I give you the homework. Make two sentences. Make two sentences for showing the ability. Ability. And two sentences for showing permission. And two sentences for showing future action. This is your homework. Right now only we have seen for showing the ability we can use can could. Then make one sentence of can and make one sentence for could. Now again two sentences you have to make to show the permission by using can, could, may. Okay. Now again two sentences you have to make to show the future action by using shall and will. So this is your homework. Now in the next video we'll see the use of may, might and must or should. Till then bye bye, take care and thank you.